This episode is brought to you by the Music for Scientists album, now available on all streaming services. To start listening, check out the link in the description. Tyrannosaurus rex has been everyone's favorite dinosaur for more than 100 years, and a century of study has given us incredible insights into what this terrible lizard looked like and the role it played in the Cretaceous world. But even though we're learning more all the time, the popular image of T-Rex seems to be stuck in the past. Now, new techniques and new fossils are turning our thinking about these fearsome predators on its head, and it is time to meet the real T-Rex. Skeletons of this gigantic dinosaur were first discovered back in the early 1900s. The first paleontologists that studied them saw rows of deadly, sharp, serrated teeth and long, powerful legs, and rightly concluded that they belonged to a fearsome predator. This dinosaur, Tyrannosaurus rex, lived about 68 to 65 million years ago, at the end of the Cretaceous period. It was one of the biggest land predators of all time. Since then, T-Rex has been immortalized in books, films, and cuddly plushies as the iconic dinosaur. But if you ask someone to actually draw a T-Rex from memory, there's a big chance that most will draw it Godzilla style, upright and balanced on its tail, with its little arms tucked uselessly next to its chest. The first T-Rex skeletons were actually mounted this way, and nobody questioned it for a long time. But the discovery of new fossils and a renewal of interest in the 1970s led to a so-called dinosaur renaissance, which transformed how we see these ancient creatures. Scientists reanalyzed the skeleton of T-Rex and saw that it was much more likely to have a horizontal spine with its back flat and its tail in the air. After this, museum skeletons were remounted, illustrations were updated in science books, and even popular films like Jurassic Park showed T-Rex as an agile, crouching hunter. But studies have shown that many people still get it wrong. Researchers think that it's because there's still so much kitschy stuff out there, like cookie cutters and stuffed toys, that have the out-of-date upright posture. Nevertheless, there's been more than 100 years of paleontology since T-Rex was first discovered, and new techniques have taught us a lot about what they were really like. For one, it looks like their tiny arms might not be totally useless. Sure, yes, T-Rex does have comically tiny arms, and for a long time, scientists wondered how those arms could do much of anything. But paleontologists speaking at a conference in 2018 presented some evidence that they were more flexible and useful than previously thought. The researchers used X-ray imagery and computer models to look at the joints of some T-Rex's modern relatives, specifically turkeys and alligators. Their research hasn't been published yet, but they propose that those tiny arms could actually have brought prey in close for a bite. However, while its arms may have been a bit better than we imagined, its legs are a bit of a letdown. T-Rex's long, sturdy leg bones have been used in the past to argue that they could run fast, like an ostrich. But because the muscles and tendons that actually do the running aren't preserved in the fossil record, estimates haven't been very precise. You can't just guess based on a smaller animal scaled up, because big animals like T-Rex put proportionally way more strain on their bones and muscles compared to smaller ones. Using different methods, scientists have suggested top speeds that range from 18 to more than 70 kilometers per hour? That's a bit of a mixed bag. A study in 2017 took a new approach, combining biomechanical simulations with measurements of stress on the skeleton. And this revealed that if they even tried to run, it would put too much force on their leg bones, causing them to fracture. So T-Rex was probably limited to a fast walk or a birdie sort of jog. Basically, it works out to a maximum speed of around 30 kilometers per hour. Which means that an Olympic sprinter would easily be able to outrun one, though not for very long. Also, it means I definitely couldn't. And while new techniques are giving us new insight into old fossils, new fossils are turning up that change our thinking too, which brings us to the feather question. In the last few decades, remarkably preserved fossils are revealing that all kinds of dinosaurs had soft, downy feathers, including relatives of T-Rex. Dilongparadoxus, a small ancestor of T-Rex, was discovered to have simple proto-feathers in 2004. And the 9-meter-long Eutyrannus, described in 2012, is the largest feathered dinosaur discovered yet. It was previously thought that maybe only the smaller dinosaurs had feathers, because those small bodies tend to need more insulation than big ones. But huge, fluffy Eutyrannus made us think again. Soon, the idea of feathered bodies expanded to include all tyrannosaurs, including T-Rex, because scientists think a trait like that isn't easily lost by evolution. But a study in 2017 analyzed brand new fossils of T-Rex skin, which were scaly, not feathered. These two conflicting points of view have sparked some pretty intense debate among paleontologists, intense enough that, like, we don't want to get into it. But this is definitely a mystery we won't be able to solve for sure until we have more fossils. We don't know this 100%, but it's possible baby T-Rex may have been born fluffy with insulating feathers all over its body. Adults could have retained a few feathery bits here and there, but the matter is far from settled. In a way, though, that's exciting. It shows how much there still is to learn about something we think we know so well, like this familiar staple of every six-year-old's toy chest. Who knows what we will learn in the next 100 years? In retrospect, it's easy to poke fun at those old, incorrect museum mounts of T-Rex and other dinosaurs. But science is a process of sifting through ideas and discarding the ones that don't hold up to experimentation. These ideas, right and wrong, are celebrated in the song The Idea from the album Music for Science. The song also has an original music video that fuses original artwork and machine learning, just like the whole album ponders the intersection between art and science. If that sounds like it might be your jam, you can start listening to Music for Scientists at the link in the description.